Aloha, I'm Ramina Van Dyken, MD from Out of the Doldrums. Have you ever heard of a food called Kon-yac? This root vegetable, which is native to East Asia, has been used for centuries in traditional Chinese and Japanese medicine, and it's a popular ingredient in many Asian dishes. In recent years, it has gained popularity as a dietary supplement and ingredient in low-calorie, low-carb foods. Have you ever heard of miracle noodles? Yep, that's Kon-yac. In this video, we'll explore the rich history of Kon-yac, its traditional uses, processing techniques, health benefits, and how to eat this interesting root vegetable. Kon-yac, which is scientifically known as Amorphophallus Kon-yac, is a perennial plant that grows in subtropical and tropical regions of East Asia and Northern Africa. It's also known as elephant yam or Kon-yaku. It's also earned the nickname Devil's Tongue. Oh, and I can see why. In traditional medicine, it has been used to treat a variety of ailments, including asthma, cough, and skin disorders. Did you know that in China, Kon-yac has been used as a dietary supplement for over 2,000 years? In this video, we will review the cultivation and processing of Kon-yac, its health benefits, and how to incorporate it in your diet, if you want to. Lastly, we'll be discussing the risks of Kon-yac. Yes, you heard right, there are some risks to eating Kon-yac, and it might not be a good dietary addition for everybody. Let's start with the cultivation and processing of Kon-yac. Kon-yac is a perennial plant that grows in subtropical and tropical regions that have high temperatures and high rainfall. The plant can grow up to 1.5 meters tall, and it has large leaves that can reach up to 40 centimeters in length. This plant grows underground tubers, and it is these tubers that are harvested and used for cooking and medicinal purposes. Kon-yac tubers take roughly 3 whole years to mature before they begin to flower. They are harvested in the autumn season after the plant has flowered and the leaves have withered. To harvest the tubers, farmers dig deep into the soil and carefully remove the tubers from the plant's root system. The harvested tubers are then washed, peeled, and cut into small pieces. After the Kon-yac tubers are harvested and cut, they're usually processed to create Kon-yac flour, noodles, and other food products. The tubers are first boiled to remove any impurities, and then they're dried and they're milled into a fine powder. This Kon-yac powder is then mixed with water and other ingredients to create various food products like Kon-yac noodles, Kon-yac jelly, and Kon-yac rice. So what is it about Kon-yac that gives it its purported health benefits? Well, it has a really high concentration of a soluble dietary fiber called glucomannan. Glucomannan is a type of polysaccharide that has been shown to have a range of health benefits, and it makes up about 40% of the entire plant's tuber. This glucomannan absorbs a large amount of water, up to 10 times its weight. When glucomannan absorbs the water, it forms a thick, gel-like substance. This gel-like substance is heavy, and when eaten, it expands and it takes up significant space in the stomach. This can create a feeling of fullness and may help to reduce appetite and promote weight loss. Because of this ability to absorb so much water, as well as its stability, film forming, thickening, and emulsifying properties, Kon-yac glucomannan is used as a food additive. It's added to noodles and tofu, and it's traditionally eaten in the form of Kon-yac jelly. As a nutritional supplement, Kon-yac glucomannan is used to treat many medical conditions. To sum it all up, Kon-yac glucomannan has numerous biological activities, including anti-diabetic and blood sugar lowering, cholesterol lowering, anti-obesity, laxative, prebiotic, and anti-inflammatory activities. Let's review these health benefits in more detail. Anti-obesity activity. It's no secret that we're seeing more and more obesity in modern society. Kon-yac is low in calories and high in fiber. When it absorbs water and forms that thick, heavy, gel-like substance, we feel full. Adding to this, when taken with meals, Kon-yac glucomannan decreases the rate by which food exits the stomach and enters into our intestines for absorption. This makes us feel fuller for longer. As a result, we eat less. Many studies done in humans show that Kon-yac glucomannan can alleviate postprandial blood glucose levels or blood sugar levels after eating, and it can improve lipid metabolism. Because of this, glucomannan also has cholesterol-lowering effects, even at low doses of less than 4 grams per day. A recent randomized placebo-controlled double-blind crossover clinical trial in diabetic subjects, 3.6 grams per day of Kon-jack glucomannan decreased LDL cholesterol by 21% and improved the total cholesterol to high-density lipoprotein cholesterol, or HDLC, ratio by 16%. That's pretty impressive. It does this by blocking uptake in the gut and increasing excretion of cholesterol into bile, which gets excreted in our bowel movements. Another study looked at 22 overweight, sedentary men. They supplemented with Kon-jack glucomannan for 8 weeks. All participants got 1,500 milligrams of Kon-jack glucomannan, and half of them were randomized to a total body exercise program. The other half stayed sedentary. They looked for weight loss, body composition, blood parameters, and physical performance. After 8 weeks, they found reductions in body mass, fat mass, total cholesterol, and LDL in both the exercising and sedentary groups. Lastly, a systematic literature review paper reviewed 14 studies and confirmed that Kon-jack glucomannan significantly lowered total cholesterol, LDL cholesterol, triglycerides, body weight, and fasting blood glucose. They saw no effect on HDL cholesterol or blood pressure, though. This review found an average reduction in LDL cholesterol of 16 milligrams per deciliter. This is actually quite respectable. We know that for each 1 milligram per deciliter reduction in a patient's LDL, their relative risk of having a coronary heart disease event is decreased by 1%. So a 16 milligram per deciliter reduction in LDL cholesterol could decrease risk of a cardiac event by 16%. That's significant. Kon-jack's also a laxative, and it contributes to our microbiome health. Kon-jack glucomannan is what we call a bulk-forming laxative, meaning it adds bulk to bowel movements. Kon-jack flour is a rich source of dietary fiber. This fiber absorbs water, which is what adds the bulk to the stool. This dietary fiber is a prebiotic, meaning it's food for the beneficial bacteria in our gut. When we feed the beneficial gut bacteria, they flourish and the unhealthy gut bacteria don't. This fiber is fermented by the gut bacteria to produce anti-inflammatory short-chain fatty acids. That whole process allows the so-called healthy gut bacteria to flourish, so we have a healthier microbiome. At the end of the day, Kon-jack fiber has been shown to improve constipation and increase bowel movement frequency. Kon-jack has anti-inflammatory activities. In addition to its many health benefits, researchers have discovered certain antioxidant and anti-inflammatory compounds in Kon-jack glucomannan. They found potential benefit in rheumatoid arthritis, thyroid disorders, and seasonal allergies. We know that chronic low-grade inflammation is harmful, and the anti-inflammatory effects of Kon-jack may help reduce the risk of chronic diseases such as heart disease, cancer, and arthritis. So we talked about the health benefits of Kon-jack. Now I have to talk about that warning. Remember how Kon-jack glucomannan absorbs up to 10 times its weight in water? Then it forms this thick, heavy gel? Well, that gel can be dangerous. If we don't consume enough water with our Kon-jack, we can get blockages of the esophagus, throat, or intestine. It could even become a choking hazard if the fiber becomes clogged and stuck in the esophagus before it gets to the stomach. The fiber can even swell more and it can really get stuck. So please, 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 please drink plenty of water when consuming Kon-jack or glucomannan. We even see that consuming large amounts of Kon-jack glucomannan supplements without adequate water intake can lead to GI discomfort in the form of diarrhea, bloating, and gas. Therefore, again, please drink plenty of water when consuming Kon-jack or glucomannan supplements. And if you have any known esophageal problems, you might want to avoid Kon-jack. Okay, so we've reviewed some of the health benefits of Kon-jack. Now, this is a strange food and probably new to most of us. So how do we incorporate it into our regular diet? Well, Kon-jack is most commonly used in the form of noodles, which are often called shirataki noodles. These noodles are made from Kon-jack flour and water, and they are very low in calories and low in carbs. They also make you feel full quickly, so you end up eating less calories. I have a link in the description below that will take you to my Amazon affiliate page where I have links to my favorite types of Kon-jack shirataki noodles and other Kon-jack products. Here are a few ways to use shirataki noodles in your cooking. You could use it as a pasta substitute. Use shirataki noodles instead of regular pasta in whatever your favorite pasta dish is. They have a neutral flavor and a chewy texture that can be a good replacement for spaghetti or fettuccine. You can use them in stir fries. Add shirataki noodles to your stir fries for a low-carb alternative to rice or noodles. You can use them in soups. Use shirataki noodles in the place of regular noodles in soups or stews. Besides noodles, konjac comes in other forms. There's konjac rice. It's another low-carb alternative to traditional rice. It can be used in any recipe that calls for rice, such as stir-fries or pilafs. To prepare it, you just rinse the konjac rice thoroughly and you cook it in boiling water for a few minutes. There's konjac flour, which is a gluten-free alternative to wheat flour, and it can be used in baking. It's often used to make low-carb bread, cakes, and cookies. However, because konjac flour absorbs water differently than wheat flour, it may require some experimenting to get the right texture in your recipes. You can have konjac chips. They're a healthy and crunchy snack. You just thinly slice the konjac root and then you bake or air fry until crispy. You can season them with salt, pepper, or whatever spice you desire. There's konjac soup. Konjac can be used to thicken soups and stews. It has that gelatinous texture when it's cooked. Or you can simply add konjac noodles, rice, or flour to your soup or stew recipe and cook until the desired consistency is reached. So, to wrap it all up, konjac is a versatile plant with a rich history of medicinal and culinary use. It grows best in subtropical and tropical regions, and it's harvested in the autumn season. The harvested tubers are then processed to create various food products like konjac flour and noodles. Its high content of glucomannan has made it a valuable component of traditional medicine in East Asia, and its low-calorie, low-carb properties have made it popular in modern diets. The processing techniques used to turn konjac into products like shirataki noodles and konjac flour have made it more accessible to people all over the world. This versatile plant is easy to incorporate into your diet and can help improve your overall health and well-being. Have you tried konjac before? If so, how do you like to prepare it? Let us know in the comments below. I hope you found this video informative and applicable. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. If you want to show us some real support, subscribe. Until next time, stay healthy and aloha.